Alright guys, this is episode 2 of the Homes and Construction Show, a continuation of the previous one, which was part 1, where we were talking more about Airbnb business. My name is Francis Emukule, and welcome to the Homes and Construction Show, part 2. In the previous part, we left off at the point where Chris was telling us that he had 28 units, of which Sammy was managing and Sammy owned. And a question lingered in my mind from that time of that episode. I was wondering, Chris, how many of the 28 do you own? But before we get there, I also want to note that as we started in the other first episode, we didn't touch on what Airbnb is. So now, being that, because you're educating us, I'm also getting educated here, just a local Ugandan, what is Airbnb? I don't know how you're going to define it, how it came about, whatever it is, just in a nutshell, paint a picture of what Airbnb is. Then I'll break it down for the rest of the people.
Thank you so much, Francis. Maybe to paint a picture, Airbnb is just like a third-party booking platform. There are quite a number. It's just that Airbnb just pioneered. But there are many. There's Booking.com, there's TripAdvisor, there's Turnkey, there is VRBO. Actually, some don't even work here, but there are many. To break down Airbnb, since it's more like the face of the space or the niche, Airbnb is an idea that started in 2008. Okay, and the way it started was because when you hear the word Airbnb, it's airbed and breakfast. That's where it came from. In other words, people we are giving guests airbeds to share space with them, and in the morning they would give them breakfast.
You know what I get when you say airbeds? These beds that they blow air in.
Yeah, something like that. Whatever you want to call it. We don't have so many of them here.
But probably that's how it started. Could have been airbeds. Okay.
Airbeds and breakfast. That's how the idea started. And the other question was, how many out of the 28
do you own?
Belong to me? I'm going to be honest with you. There is more need to manage than there is to start money business.
So is that for your case or just generally for Uganda?
Generally, I must say, because for my case, I should say I own like 20% of the 28.
And you manage 80%?
80% is just management, because there is a huge work of management. Because there is so many people that have their money to invest in the business, but they don't know how. They don't have the time to manage. When I realized that was the case, I was like, I'm going to triple down on the management and on starting. Maybe in the future.
You will start more.
More.
Actually, that's a mentality that very many rich business people do. You find that a man owns a company, but he just owns it, but he's not the CEO. He leaves everything to everyone. And then for him, he oversees from the top. So I think that makes sense.
Yeah, I believe with time, maybe we can look at investing more. But you must understand, this is, the idea is not even 20 years old. It's not even 20 years old.
It's 2008. Yeah, it's not 20 years old.
So if it is not 20 years old worldwide, how much more in Japan? Probably it's not even 16 years old. So it's a new idea. We are just managing as we see how things go.
So, management.
Yeah.
What do you do as a manager? If I've given you a property, Chris, manage for me this property, what should I expect from you?
That's an interesting question, because management comes with, first of all, what I'm going to do for you, I'm going to make sure I feed you with clients, because you realize some people entirely depend on a third-party platform. Someone will list their house on Airbnb, maybe even on Booking.com, they will get to sleep. What I do actually, I also do social media marketing. For those properties. So what I'm trying to do is to pull all the traffic towards you. Yeah. You are only on the third-party booking platforms. I'm pumping content every week on social media. So chances are high, I'm going to get both from third-party booking platforms and social media as well. So I'm going to, first of all, get your clients. We are going to improve your occupancy rate, mm-hmm. if you are maybe operating at 40% occupancy rate, we can bring you up to maybe 65 or 70.
Mm. Uh-huh.
Also, because it comes in two packages. Firstly, you can say, me, what I'm going to do with you, Chris, I'm just going to give you my properties, all I want are the clients. When you give me clients, we can talk about
the payment.
The payment.
Mm.
Another person will say, I have my Airbnb, but I don't have the time. I'm not even interested in running the business hands-on.
Mm-hmm.
I can give it to you. You run the business. We just talk numbers at the end of someone's stay.
Mm.
So, for the first case, I will charge 15% because that's more like a broker.
Mm-hmm.
I'm doing what Airbnb would be doing for you.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm charging 15%. For this other case, I would charge 25% because I'm doing everything. Mm. You're all passing. Yes.
So that means if I own this property and you're managing it, I list it on Airbnb,
mm-hmm.
then for you pump the traffic.
Mm-hmm.
So whoever comes bounces. So the client bounce off you on social media straight to the platform. To the third party platform, or it's vice versa. They come to you, then you refer them to the platform?
No, actually it's different.
Mm.
There is the part of the third party booking platform.
This is the Airbnb
platform. Yes, if I'm going to manage for you only in that wise,
mm-hmm.
You're going to make me a co-host.
Oh,
and
co-host.
What
does that mean?
Co-host means you are the major host, the funds come into your account.
And then
but
for you,
when it comes to interaction and engaging the client and trying to negotiate the deal, and
that's
guy.
You.
Yeah, you're just on the platform to oversee what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Then after I have negotiated and closed business, that's now when we can talk the numbers and payment.
Mm-hmm.
That's one way. The other way, I don't actually get traffic from social media to the third-party booking platforms.
Okay.
No. Social media, it has its own audience. Also, the third-party booking platforms are third-party booking platforms. Because there is a person who is going to say, I would rather save some dollars booking through the app and use social media. No. Let me put it right. I would rather go use social media and save some dollars instead of go through the third-party booking platform and have to pay the platform. Because this is how it works. When somebody's booking, they pay the platform. Even me, from whom the house has been booked, I also pay the platform.
Mm.
That's how it works.
So social media works in such a way that Obedanga broker,
yes,
slide into your DM.
Uh-huh.
Chris, I need a place to sleep for 3 days. Can you get me one?
Exactly.
And you take them there.
Something like that.
Ah.
Yeah.
Okay, that's smart.
Yeah.
Hi. Well done.
That's smart.
I want to be like you when I grow up.
Thanks.
Well, Chris, interesting information. There's this thing you talked about, the cards.
Yeah.
The cards. Now, if I don't have a credit card, what do I do? Because we're talking terms of someone booking from Chelsea, from Manchester. Mm. I'm a Ugandan.
Mm.
And I want Okujaku Airbnb on one of your 28 units. Nkola Antianga Dinamo Bama Neyoka.
So if you are Ugandan, it's two ways or three ways. Either you can do cash, you can do mobile money, you can do wire transfer. Basically,
does the platform provide that?
No. Then it's not platform. If it's platform,
it's now
then
social
either,
media.
If it is social media, then we are talking cash, mobile money, or wire transfer.
Mm.
But once it's platform, then you just have to have Visa or MasterCard or whatever. Many.
So where is the money sweeter? Platform, third party, Visa. Where?
Money is money.
It doesn't matter.
Money is money.
All right. Yes. So for guys that are wondering what Airbnb is, bro, Airbnb is another way of renting. Only that, this one is a bit different. The way it's kusasula mwezi mulamba. Oli at liberty. Ogamba nti ngenda kubera ko mu nyumba ya Chris nenda yabera ina kwezi enaku satu ne family yange ne mchala wange no jobera o just for that short period of time no waka without you paying andiro dibichi bichi. Now Chris, back to you. This is a very good space you have here. So wemba nyingira wano, what do you offer?
Okay, that's a good question. Wowoja fe wano osangawo okay eranga kyolo za kisinzira kubanga kisinzira usually client ngabogoze guest ngabogoze kubanga omuntu owena kusatu bana kunya tetumukwata ngo omuntu wa miezi 3 tetumukwata ngo omuntu wa miezi 4 njo omuntu owena kusatu tosobola muganda atogenda tani kokweza sulira masanyalaze na amazi
owena owe miezi 3 owena kusatu
short stays boja jangu na mereyo jangu na ngoyezo
uleta tulo
leta tulo
ade sabuni
ni sabuni tusobola mungu lya oya gati
sukari amanja gala chai
sukari ajijide mu mere
eh
kuba kugana ti jangu na mereyo jangu na ngoyezo eh kati oja nabyo
kati sukari half if I'm going to stay here for mbange na bed out for 2 days rachi mungu za kile ya sukari atenga mso wote kawo alika bao la ka sukari
in fact you said if you sing out to wait for me bali awagwe those short stay
what if I don't want it outside
that's when you buy your sugar and pack it and check out
okay
kati oyo ye muntu wa short stay na kuntono oyo tumukolera buli kimu na agent kugamba nti ki kwebaka na ngoye
ate wifi
wifi bivamu oyina wifi oyina washing machine oyina kiyungo kiri well stocked kiri mu microwave cooker toaster buli kimu ekintu kiri mu modern home
so omuntu w'emyezi esatu asasula amazzi
good question fact nani njagala kugamba luli nti ow'emyezi esatu tumukwata bulala bwe tukwata owena ku esatu ow'emyezi esatu togenda kukomitinga musasulira amasanyalaze because why tomanyi esa agenda gikozesa ate there are some people who will come because they know it's you paying the electricity aleke esinge blowing
even don't know why that atana, is the case
fana zilekeko atambula agenda chali emikwano gye for a week ngatasubiri so usually what we do bobosla banga pound we can get your money probably give you a discount na ife nitukwe nyumba naweza sulia utility bills water electricity tv we can actually do TV depending on our understanding yeah
kati omuntu wa longer stay do they pay more money or more of a discount
we give them very good discounts very good
discounts why but then those as members you na kusatu just on tell out maybe $40 or $30 kuba I'm short staying for a short while then ori again nokubera for a long time you can hike his stuff
kino simanyi oba tekiri meni kwogera but usually our major interests are the long stays we try to hike prices for the short stays tusobola okugezaako ba repairing why bwojjanga ogenda beerawo ennaku nnya wakati awo nga nkyali naawe ennaku nnya bwe nfuna booking nga
ya myezi
ena myezi ena kitegeeza ngenda mu foregoing I committed to you already
eba loss
so kati awo mtwalo wena kwenye na inga nchimanyi chendi mkola ni mkola risk eri waguru so kuchaji nga kasente nga kawele ya dani fakti mbanga kwe goba ku
mpa dola chukumi kwa watu wakala kwenye
mpa mtwala atambi kwa nipa naiti nyewa na Uganda baina mwa kasente
hey agapa it's fine I have a honeymoon my baby
yeah
hey by the way honeymoon so wachukubila mno
wali kuzi
wa katigotegi hati honeymoon sende teze yonge lako
no to charging a days we just have standard rates for days we don't care the event what we don't
so
allow
I can bring a house party here
no that's well, a good question but no we actually okay as long as you promise us it's going to be a house party but you will maintain the calm because you see
it's a residential home
residential everyone wants to enjoy their peace katugenda kuba music then you know when people get tired
inguli ketabuka okay
so house parties it would be maybe because there are some properties we have and it's like an entire house in its own gate
okay separate property
but for an apartment not a house
why is that most of you don't offer breakfast
it's hectic so it's in the long run for example think about me running having to run 28 units you have a Japanese you have a Chinese you have somebody from Canada so oinoba fumbira cuisine zao
they're in Uganda chikomando na buji
wagamba kujia kumiria what are you going to do when you committed already agama nkolira cuisine yo
they have to pay maybe Because you're also working within your means.
There's people who have tried that, but it's failed miserably.
Kwanu na wuji. Are in there to Facebook, maybe. Ukujawonga expatriate, right? Yeah. You can, you know. There are people that are here. Do you know that when you go to Japan, you eat Japanese food?
I don't know. I've not been to Japan.
No, I'm just saying. When you go to America, you have a burger. You have to eat a muwogo kumbacha.
That's true. Na
so when they come here,
do you know there are people who, for example, when they are Chinese, when they go to the US, they look for a Chinatown?
Yeah, I know.
Because they are looking for their own food. Mm. It happens.
Okay.
Thank you.
Anyway, that's a gray area that I don't think a lot of people in this business want to venture
in, because of the day, it's not worth the effort.
Yes, yeah, not worth the effort. Mm-hmm. I agree. So if I'm going to leave here for 8 months, am I allowed to change the position of this chair and take it there?
Perfectly fine. That's fine.
Change the design of the house?
No.
Paints are fresh?
No, you may not paint. Oh. Unless you're maintaining the colors, and you have to speak to us before you go. Mm. Mm.
This is a very interesting question that has just crossed my mind. Mm. Airbnb, what I understand, is air, bed, and breakfast. Hmm? Mm. Now to Ogambi, breakfast is a very grey area. Hmm. But are you not giving me a road deal? Considering, well, you've given me bed, which is, I don't know, which has air. Hmm. And then there's no breakfast. Hmm. Don't you think there is some... For a layman that understands things literally, hmm, what do you have to tell them in defense of that?
Okay, what used to be, hmm, when this whole idea first started, was a must.
That breakfast was a must.
Yeah, it was a must, mm-hmm, because it was part of the deal. As business kept evolving, mm, and because initially it was like home, opening your home to a stranger, so it was easy. Mm-hmm. You give them, mm-hmm, bed in the morning when you're having breakfast.
They also have breakfast.
Yeah. With you. But nowadays you're, mm, looking at someone who has maybe 1,000 units. It is purely commercial.
You can't have breakfast for 1,000 people.
You cannot. It's going to be...
with different preferences, yes?
Mm. It's going to be tight. So, somehow, somewhere, at the back of their mind, everyone knows, yes, it's Airbnb and breakfast, but I don't expect nothing,
mm,
for breakfast.
Okay. Mm. That's fair enough.
Yeah.
Now, you said, I can't have a house party here. Mm. You know? What?
You can't bring a dog. You can't bring a pet.
Oh my God. I can't bring a dog. I can't bring a pet. Why? What are the do's and don'ts?
Okay. Different house owners, different house rules.
Oh.
There's some people who are flexible too.
Beds and pets. Pet,
it's okay. You do a party. But again, when you ask me, I'll tell you it comes with an extra cost of cleaning when somebody comes with their dogs. We have tried it in the past. It didn't play out so well.
Mm.
Because somebody brought their dogs, they went in the beds, they slept with the dogs in the beds, couch, everything. You know, dogs. A lot of money when it comes to cleaning and taking out all that dog susu out of
even
the fur, taking it out of the beddings and everything. Mm. So that's where we're like, you know what?
No more.
You're stopping.
Mm.
But with a house party, like I told, it's only for conveniency. A property that is maybe a standalone, it's okay.
Mm.
Yeah.
Let's say I've booked a property or your unit in Gwalobi, and how do I confirm that I'm going to be in Tinder, I'm going to do this and this. These are the details of my property that I'm going to live in, and this is the location it is.
Okay. To break it down or make it understood clearly, Airbnb is like Uber for houses.
So there is a pin, a map?
There is an app.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. There is an app, there is a side of the guest, there is also a side of the host on the same app.
Mm-hmm.
So when the guest is maybe in Jinja and they're trying to book for a place in Tinder, first of all, they will go in the search bar, they put in Tinder.
Mm-hmm.
Now, in the feed, they're going to bring them places that are available for the dates they're trying to book
in Tinder.
Yes. Then they choose. After you have chosen, after you have chosen, now you can go ahead and chat with the guest. Mm. You also confirm availability, because there's some guests, they will leave the calendar open, yet they got a direct booking maybe from social media. Maybe they got a direct booking from a referral. So you have to go ahead and speak to the host mm-hmm. and confirm availability.
Mm-hmm. And then how do I get the details?
Okay. Once you have spoken to me and it's a deal, the dates, the calendar is open, you can go ahead and make payment. Mm-hmm. Once you make payment, Airbnb automatically is going to block off that period you have booked. No other person can book through Airbnb. Now it's done, those days are sold out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So what about the directions?
The directions, you share them with the PIN.
Mm-hmm. They shared the PIN to you.
Yeah.
With you, I mean, the service provider shares the PIN.
Yeah, the hosts also put the PIN for the location. Alternatively, you can talk. After the payment is made, you can now actually exchange contacts. Before payment, you can't. Even when you try typing your number, the system will delete it.
Hey.
Yeah. Otherwise, there wouldn't be.
Airbnb in Nakamido.
Yeah. No, but that's the only way they could do it, because many people will be coming on their platform and they talk to the guest direct. Next thing you know, they're not paying through Airbnb.
So they pay with the guest.
Yeah, they pay directly to the host. Airbnb, out of business.
Out of business.
Yeah.
Following up on the other, on the security question that you had talked about some time back. It's about how do you do the background checks of these people that are coming into these spaces, your spaces, because usually what I know that before I rent in an area, I'll get introduced to the village chair, LOC chairman, just to, you know, to know where I came from, where I was renting before, where sometimes work, see my ID if I have any, and then get a village ID. How do you do that to verify that the people you're dealing with are actually the right people?
Okay, that's nice. First of all, Airbnb as a platform itself has its own screening measures. It has its own screening measures. For example, there is things you cannot do and they will let you be on their platform. If you are Miyai, you go to this host, you break stuff, and then you don't want to pay. You go to, they pick out of pocket and pay this host. You go to another host to do the same, they will kick you out of the platform. Then us also down on the ground, we have our screening measures. First of all, when you come, whether you come through Airbnb or not, we'll take your passport.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we'll take your passport, picture of your passport, and then we also make sure to work closely with the teams on ground. We also give you house rules to sign. You can't do this. You can't bring in strangers and have them stay. You can't sublet, you know. And if
how do you know that if someone, imagine I paid you. Clearly, I've paid you 10 months, given you like maybe $2,000. Clearly, I've made you happy. And I start bringing in my friends. How do you know that those are... How do you differentiate between friends and people I'm subletting with?
The people you're subletting, because it's guests, the visitors are allowed, first of all. They're allowed to come. They're not allowed to spend a night.
How do you... I've paid... For almost 6 months.
Ombulira up front. Reservation.
But my guy.
Alternatively, what you can do, bwabango ina intentions ezo suzo omuntu. You let us know na tumuja ko details.
Okay.
If you do that, it can happen once, but it can't happen two times, I promise you. Teams on ground will tell us if it's someone we don't understand, they're spending.
Oh, money. Like the gate man.
Yes.
Ah,
also, yeah. We do regular checks. Like once in a while, the children check in the nyumba buli chimu chiri bulungi.
But is that intruding my space? Because if you entering to my bedroom to check around.
In the contract, we say at reasonable times.
What is reasonable times?
We are not going to knock at your door at midnight. Hey, we have come to do a wellness check. That would be now encroaching.
But Chris, mind what you have until Atagala, even during daytime, for you to come into my space.
I think at the end of the day, we have to keep it within the limits of reason.
Yeah, don't go to my bedroom.
For an entire month, you can't come and do a wellness check. I mean, I didn't sell you the property. I didn't. I want to come this week, even next week, you know? So it has to be kept within the bounds of reason. Yeah,
but regardless, a wellness check must be made.
Yeah, maybe once in 2 weeks, maybe once in a month.
So a wellness check must be made to ascertain the safety of the house and the state of the people in the house. True. Also to know how many people are living, or are you subletting or not?
Exactly. No, actually also it helps both you and me, because there is a time during COVID I had a guest in Buguloi. By the way, I kept that guy for like 2.5 years. But this guy got COVID.
Oh no. Mm-hmm.
So got COVID, staying in a huge apartment, 3-bedroom, alone. I'm trying to text him, guy is not answering. And the previous day we were talking. There's something we're talking about. I was supposed to go get money. So I go and I'm knocking. The doors are locked, but the guy is not responding. Bro, I even go to a point of getting a stone and now banging the door. Because I thought, maybe this guy has a problem, he has collapsed maybe. So you realize it's a two-way traffic.
Mm-hmm.
In case you have a problem, we come to do a wellness check. We can as well, we have come for a rescue.
Oh,
yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Did you help him eventually?
Yeah, we did. We had to contact his office.
And wait, why was he not opening?
He was weak.
He was weak.
I did bang, bang, bang. He forced himself, came to the door. I was like, Chris, I have COVID. Please go.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Interesting information.
Well, so this is one of the spaces that Chris operates his business in.
Mm-hmm.
So from the look of it, it looks to me like a two-bedroom.
Yeah, it's a two-bedroom.
And like I asked earlier on, what does someone get when they come to your space? And please do us the honors mm-hmm. of explaining what it is that you got right here.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So first of all, when someone comes, mm-hmm. like you see, they have a couch. This is our living room.
Mm-hmm.
They have a couch. You have a TV because you realize people come from places with different weather conditions. So we have a fan. When it gets too hot, you can switch on the fan.
Mm-hmm.
And TV console, it has Netflix and everything.
So there is
Wi-Fi. There is Wi-Fi as well.
Okay. Does Wi-Fi have a limit? Like, because it's somewhere I went, they give you Wi-Fi like 1 GB.
Mm-hmm.
Does it work on the web?
Let me just say it's unlimited.
Internet
is unlimited. Oh,
right.
Yeah.
So we have a mini dining.
Yeah.
Okay.
Simple stuff.
Mm. I see. Okay.
Yeah.
So this is a beautiful. So I look like it looks like to me it looks like the ambience plays a key role. Like you want to make someone feel like they're in the presence of affluence.
Yeah, because you see what you're doing is you're selling. You have to be competitive.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Money.
Yeah.
The place looks like has to look like money.
Place has to look nice and livable.
Yeah.
Even before actually signing. Yeah.
Okay.
Mm.
So this is the corridor.
Yeah.
See in the washing machine here.
Yeah. Laundry basket.
This is the wash area.
Yes.
Okay. So what's this?
It could be for your laundry. You could put maybe dirty laundry, clean laundry, whatever you choose to.
And see all this detergent. So maybe you also provide detergent, yeah?
Not really. Not really. This was left by a guest. So a guest will come with their own detergent. Because different guests with different choices of detergents.
Mm.
Yeah. Might buy this and they prefer this.
So where are we heading?
Right now we are going
bathroom area.
This is the bathroom area. Uh-huh. You realize we separated it from the toilet. So this is bathroom and this is toilet. Separate.
Mm-hmm.
There's some people who prefer it that way. Yeah, so here is one of the bedrooms.
This reminds me of those movies,
mm-hmm.
that has the Royal King movies of Queen Elizabeth of 1987.
Yeah.
They have these beautiful displays. And,
yeah.
Wow, this is amazing.
Yeah.
Woo!
So you really want to, do your best because, again, you're going to be hosting the best.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So you want to do your best as well. Yeah.
Gives that royalty vibes, if you ask me.
Yeah.
And this applies to also the bed area too.
Mm-hmm.
The bed is so amazing.
Yeah.
So all this, you buy them in Uganda?
No, some of the things actually come from Dubai.
Makes sense. This looks like Dubai vibes.
Yeah.
it's post environment.
Yeah, you can. Yeah, this is the master, yes. Now we are going to the minor bedroom, which is here. It also has wall cabinets and a sizable bed. And yeah.
This is the killing vibe, killing area.
Setup is you can have a seat in case you want. Yeah. This could be like your prayer mat if you want to pray, maybe.
I think at this point, I did not want to opt for a hotel when I travel.
You know, there is advantages and disadvantages of hotels and Airbnb.
Yeah, what are some of the disadvantages?
Because for a hotel, usually you don't have that privacy. Mm-hmm. You know, there is many people in the same space. Mm-hmm. But here,
there
isn't as many. Because if you're going to a hotel which has maybe 160 rooms,
yeah.
What if you find, and maybe they have capacity of like 100 people?
And everyone is in your business.
Everybody's just, you know.
If you make noise, the hotel where by no soundproof. If you make noise, you have one down on here and the other one here.
Exactly.
But here, So what's the disadvantage of Airbnb?
Well, it could be maybe the money. We charge higher than a hotel. Because we give more value than a hotel as well.
That's the disadvantage.
Yeah.
That is saying that you provide according to who can afford.
Exactly.
So in case you need anything in as far as starting, this is information I mean to say, Airbnb is concerned, this is the show you should watch from part one to part two. So my name is Francis Mokule and this is the Homes and Construction Show. I hope you enjoyed this particular episode. Make it a date next time to catch us here on Urban TV, same time, 7:45 p.m. and same place. Keep it right here, Urban TV.